Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the Fibonacci search process. Now we see that there are 7 steps involved in general. First, we have to set up 2 indices. One is called current, which is equal to 0, and the other one is called offset, which is equal to 1. The next step is to find out a Fibonacci number that is just larger than the length of the array to be searched for. And then I save that particular Fibonacci number as Fibonacci M. And then in the third step, I want to take the Fibonacci number, which is 2 positions before the Fibonacci M. And I call it Fibonacci M-2. And I also let the Fibonacci number just before Fibonacci M as Fibonacci M-1. And then I want to evaluate the current index, which is based on the particular formula shown on the slide. I want to know the offset, and then I add the offset by the Fibonacci M-2, and then I want to compare the sum with the length -1, and I want to take out the minimum of the 2 values, and then I call it as the current index. And then I put that current index into the array to see if the current index gives me the target or not. Of course, if the current index gives me the target, then the search is done. Otherwise, I have to consider 2 cases. If the value corresponding to the current index is actually smaller than the target, then I change the offset to be just the current index. Else, if the current index points to a value that is larger than the target, then I keep the offset value unchanged. After that, I change the Fibonacci M to Fibonacci M-1. That means I want to take the previous Fibonacci number as the current Fibonacci number. Finally, I have to repeat steps 3 to 6 until I see the condition as follows. The Fibonacci M is smaller than or equal to 1, or the target is found by saying that the current index gives me a value that is equal to the target. Now, let us see the meaning of a Fibonacci sequence. So, in order to set up a Fibonacci sequence, I have to start with 2 numbers, which are 1 and 0. So, 0 comes first, followed by 1. And then I can add up the 2 numbers to get the next number. So, you can see that 0 plus 1 gives me 1. And then 1 plus 1 gives me 2. 1 plus 2 gives me 3. 2 plus 3 gives me 5, and so on. So if I repeat this process, I'm able to get the Fibonacci sequence. The purpose of using Fibonacci numbers in a search process is like that. In using the Fibonacci numbers, I can use them to determine the position of chopping the array by just using addition or subtraction. Remember, in our binary search process, we need to do division to find out the middle index, but actually the division process is more computationally costly. That means it usually takes more steps to do division than to do addition or subtraction. That means Fibonacci numbers can help us determine the position to chop the array in a more effective approach. Now, let us see an example. Suppose now I have 20 numbers and I want to search for 34 from these 20 numbers. How can I do it by using the Fibonacci search process? Before doing so, I have to set up the current index to be 0 and the offset index to be 1. And now you can see that the offset index is actually smaller than 0. That means it is not inside the array. That's why I put the offset index on the left-hand side of the current index. And now we see that the length of the array is now 20. And the Fibonacci number that is just larger than 20 is 21. And we can see the Fibonacci sequence here. And we say that Fibonacci M is 21. And of course, Fibonacci M-1 is 13, which is just the previous Fibonacci number before 21. And Fibonacci M-2 is 8, which is just 2 numbers before the Fibonacci M number. So after I have determined the Fibonacci numbers to use, I can put the appropriate values into the current index calculation. So offset is -1, and Fibonacci M-2 is 8. So offset plus Fibonacci n minus 2 is 7. And 7 and 19 compared together, 7 would be a smaller one. So that's why I would use 7 as the current index. Now, the current index is changed to 7. And I want to check that whether this index value corresponds to a value that is equal to the target or not. And now we see that the current index gives me 25, which is actually smaller than the target. If it is the case, I have to ignore the elements between the offset and the current. That means we don't need to consider the values between the offset and the current, because the numbers are sorted. If the current index gives me a value smaller than the target, I don't need to check again the values between the offset and the current, because those numbers would be smaller than the target for sure. How can I ignore those numbers? I can just assign the current index to the offset variable. So you can see that both offset and current would become 7 for now. And in this situation, I no longer need to check the values before the offset. That's why those numbers are shaded in gray. And then I have to repeat the process of finding out the Fibonacci numbers. The idea is to shift one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers corresponding to m, m-1, and n-2. So after the shifting to the left, Fibonacci m is equal to 13, Fibonacci m-1 is now 8, Fibonacci n-2 is 5. And after having these Fibonacci numbers, I find out the current index, which is equal to 12. Why is it 12? Now, offset is 7, and Fibonacci n-2 is 5. So 7 plus 5 is 12. So the minimum of 12 and 19 would be just 12. Now you can see that I put the current index to a new position, which is index 12. And I check that the current index corresponds to a value of 38, which is actually larger than the target, which is 34. In this situation, we are sure that the target is actually between the offset and the current. In this situation, I don't have to change the offset index. Now we just want to focus on the values between the offset and the current. And then I have to repeat the process of finding out the Fibonacci numbers. Now I have to shift one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers m, m-1, and m-2. So now we have Fibonacci number m equals 8, Fibonacci m-1 equals 5, and Fibonacci number m-2 equals 3. After getting these Fibonacci numbers, I want to use them to find out the current index. Offset is 7, and Fibonacci m-2 is 3, so 7 plus 3 is 10. 10 and 19 compared together, I can get a smaller number, which is 10. So the current index now becomes 10. Now I put the current index to number 10 index, and we see that the value corresponding to the current index is now 31, which is actually smaller than 34, being the target. In this situation, we have to ignore the elements between offset and current. That's why I have to shade them in gray. Why can I do so? Because I'm sure that I don't need to handle the values between the offset and the current, because they are actually smaller than the target. Now the offset becomes the current. The way to ignore those numbers is to make the offset equal to the current. In this case, I no longer need to check the values before the offset index. Now you see that the offset becomes 10, and the current index is still 10. Now I want to shift one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers in the previous step. So Fibonacci m is 5, Fibonacci m-1 is 3, and Fibonacci number m-2 is 2. Now, after we have got those Fibonacci numbers, I can try to put them into the current index calculation. Now the offset index is 10, and Fibonacci m-2 is 12. So the sum of these two numbers would be 12 for now. 12 and 19 compared together would give me a smaller value of 12, so the current index becomes 12. So now I want to see whether the current index gives me a value that is equal to the target. In this case, the current index gives me a value of 38, which is actually smaller than the target, as it is 34. So now I'm sure that the target is between the offset and the current indices. In this situation, I don't need to change the offset variable. I just keep the offset unchanged. Now let me go to the next iteration. I want to shift one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers found. So now I have Fibonacci m equals 3, Fibonacci m minus 1 equals 2, and Fibonacci m minus 2 equals 1. Now, when I have these Fibonacci numbers, I can put them to find out the current index. So offset is 10, Fibonacci m minus 2 is 1, so the sum of these two quantities would be 11. 11 and 19 compared together would give me a smaller value of 11. So the current index will become 11. Now the current index gives me a value of 34, which is actually equal to the target. It means that the target can be found at index 11. And of course, in this situation, the search is complete. Let us take a look at another situation. Suppose I want to find out 52 from these sorted numbers. Now I have 20 numbers. And the first step is to set up the current and offset indices. The current index is 0 and the offset index is minus 1. Since the offset index is smaller than the current, I just put it outside the array. And now we have 20 elements. So I want to find out the Fibonacci number that is just larger than 20. And I see that it is 21. So based on 21, which is called Fibonacci M, I can find out Fibonacci M minus 1 as 13 and Fibonacci M minus 2 as 8. Okay, we have got those Fibonacci numbers, and I want to put them into the equation to find out the current index. Offset is minus 1, and Fibonacci M minus 2 is 8, so the sum would be 7. 7 compared to 19 would give me a smaller value of 7, so the current index would become 7. When I see the current index as 7, I want to get the corresponding value. Now I see that it is 25. But 25 is actually smaller than the target, which is 52. It just means that I have to ignore those elements between the offset and the current. How can I do so? I can assign the current index value to the offset variable. In this case, I no longer need to check the values before the offset. That's why those numbers are grayed out. And then I can shift one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers found in the previous step. That means I want to do the iteration again. Now, Fibonacci M is 13, Fibonacci M minus 1 is 8, Fibonacci M minus 2 is 5. After having those Fibonacci numbers, I can try to put them into the current index calculation. Offset is now 7, and Fibonacci M minus 2 is 5. That's why I get 12 as the answer to the sum of offset and Fibonacci M minus 2. When 12 is compared to 19, I see that 12 is the smaller value, that's why the current index would become 12. The current index now gives me a number of 38, which is actually smaller than the target of 52. In this case, I have to ignore the elements between the offset and the current indices, because I'm sure that they are unable to contain our target. How can I do this action? I just assign the current index to the offset index. And then in this situation, I no longer need to check the values before the offset index. That's why more numbers are grayed out. Now I go to the next iteration. I want to shift one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers found previously. So now Fibonacci M is 8, Fibonacci M minus 1 is 5, Fibonacci M minus 2 is 3. Now after I have got those Fibonacci numbers, I can try to put them into the equation to find out the current index. Offset is now 15. Fibonacci M minus 2 is only 2. So 15 plus 2 is 17. And then I want to find out the smaller value between 17 and 19. And of course, I would get 17. So 17 becomes the current index. Now the current index of 17 gives me a value of 56, which is actually larger than the target. That means the target is between the offset and the current in principle. In this situation, I don't need to change the offset. I can keep it unchanged. Now I want to shift one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers. So now, Fibonacci M is 3, Fibonacci M minus 1 is 2, Fibonacci n minus 2 is now 1. Now we have those Fibonacci numbers, and now I'm going to use those numbers to find out the current index. Offset is now 15, Fibonacci number n minus 2 is 1, so I get 16 as the answer to the sum of offset and Fibonacci n minus 2. 16 compared to 19, I would get 16 as the smaller value. That's why current would become 16. Now when the current becomes 16, I can get the value of 51, which is actually smaller than the target. In this situation, I want to ignore the elements between the offset and the current. Now the offset is actually having an index equal to the current by doing the assignment. In this situation, I no longer need to check the values before the offset. So you can see more numbers are grayed out. Now I want to shift one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers. So now I can see that Fibonacci m is 2, Fibonacci m minus 1 is 1, and Fibonacci m minus 2 is also 1. Now after finding out those Fibonacci numbers, I'm going to find out the current index. Offset is 16 and Fibonacci m minus 2 is 1. So I have 17 as the answer to the sum. 17 compared to 19 would have 17 being the smaller number, so current would become 17. Now the current index gives me a value of 56, which is actually larger than the target of 52. In principle, the target should be between the offset and the current indices. In this situation, I don't want to change the offset. Now I want to do the iteration again by shifting one number to the left for each of the Fibonacci numbers. And now Fibonacci m is 1, Fibonacci m minus 1 is 1, Fibonacci m minus 2 is 0. Now we see that Fibonacci m becomes 1. That means I don't need to do any further iteration. The iteration should stop here. And at this stage, I find that the current index is giving me a value of 56, which is not equal to the target. Since it is not equal to the target and the iteration has stopped, it means that the search has failed. That means I'm not able to find out the target from the given sorted numbers using Fibonacci search. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions at the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.